I don't even know what the series is called, but I'm already getting Violet Soaringale vibes.
And I feel like this confirmed it.
Hey guys, what's up? It's Cort. Welcome back to my channel, or if you're new here, hi, my name is Cort. I do bookish and outdoor lifestyle content here on my channel. So if that sounds like your jam, I'm out of breath. If that sounds like your thing, make sure to subscribe and stick around. But for today's video, excuse me, Mr. Airplane. For today's video, we're going to be doing yet again another reading vlog, and I am so thrilled to share it with you guys because we're going to be reading this. I don't even know what the series is called. What is the series called? Throne of Glass is actually the book club pick of the month for my book club here in Utah, and I'm so thrilled. Honestly, I've been like intimidated to read any Sarah J Maas books. I have, well, you can't see them, but over on the corner, I have the first three books in the ACOTAR series. I've had them for over a year. I've been too intimidated to read them. They were hyped up. I was nervous. So I just kept putting it off. I am still putting it off. Like I said, this month my book club picked out Throne of Glass as our read, and I really have no choice. So I am getting excited. I'm really pumped to get into it. I also picked up Assassin's Blade because I believe this is a prequel to it. I've been told it is short stories. You do not have to read this before this, but you can. I think just for the sake of time and making sure I read it in time for my book club discussion, I'm gonna read this first and then I'm going to read this after. But I am so excited to jump into my first Sarah J Maas book. It honestly doesn't look too thick, doesn't look too scary. How many pages are in here? Okay. There are 404 pages in this book, and I feel like it'll go quickly. I hope it will. I'm super pumped to share today's reading vlog with you. I don't know how long it will take me to read this book. I know my last reading vlog, it took me a few days to get through the book. There were a lot of controversial thoughts going on in my head as I was reading that book, but for these, I heard nonstop good things. I'm super pumped, and I cannot wait to share it with you guys. So let's jump into Throne of Glass. Let's get reading. I got some tabs, colored pens, and highlighters. Clearly I went for a blue theme that I think matches pretty aesthetically. But yeah, I don't know. I didn't want to have to get up again. So I got these. So if I need to highlight or mark anything up, I can. Here we go. I'm so excited. So I'm only on page 2, but I'm already getting Violet Soaringale vibes in the best way, and I know this book was written before then. I'm just saying because I've read Fourth Wing before this. Just on page 2, Selena says, "When she woke every morning, she repeated the same words, 'I will not be afraid.' For a year, those words had meant the difference between breaking and bending. They had kept her from shattering in the darkness of the mines. Not that she let the captain know any of that." And it makes me think of when Violet Soaringale said, "I will not die today." So I'm already vibing with it. She have a thing for the prince that they have like a family history, they don't like each other. I think that's what, I'm already confused. There's a lot of people in this book with big names. I mean, page 8, they're already projecting that she's gonna like fall in love with him. Maybe. Princes are not supposed to be handsome. They're sniveling, stupid, repulsive creatures. This, how unfair of him to be royal and beautiful. I mean, shoot your shot. Hey guys, new outfit, new day. Day two of reading Throne of Glass. I'm very excited. I didn't read really too much at all last night. I got to chapter 4, page 21, and I've already got some thoughts. The damn train. I have already got some thoughts so far as like the writing style and like how I'm enjoying it, even though I'm only like a smidge into it. And that is simply due to third person POV. I'm just not used to reading that. So it did catch me off guard when I was reading it at first, but you know what? It's starting to flow. It's starting to get good and easy. And I feel like it could be a very fast paced read. When I started it yesterday, you guys obviously saw, I was like, wait. And I think in the first five pages, there was like six or seven characters introduced, and they have first and last names, and they're obviously like fantasy big names, and I was just like, what did I sign up for? But not to fear, as I started reading more and more, it did start to just like flow and feel fast and feel like it was gonna be a good read. That is to say, I'm on page 21, so we will see. We will see if my prediction of enjoying this book is correct or not. I just wanted to like intro this little part because, you know, I'm about to go sit on the couch. You're about to see a little montage of me reading and highlighting and all that fun stuff. But yeah, that's that. Let's get into reading.
So I'm only on page 38, but I feel like I've been reading for a hot minute. Like I've been in this world for a bit now, but in the best way. I pretty much forgot I was reading. I've also been tabbing and highlighting like almost every page at this point, which is so exciting. And I think this is the first book that I've ever made predictions or like thoughts to myself, I guess. Usually I just highlight things I like, things that make me laugh, things that make me sad. But all of these kind of like muted blues are predictions. So on page 8, I basically tabbed this and said that Selena is gonna fall for the prince. And then here, I predicted that the forest and the fairies are going to help her either escape or win. And then here, Dorian, I think he's falling for her too. And I feel like this confirmed it, but I don't know. I don't want to get ahead of myself. I'm really enjoying reading right now. And also, just seeing all of these tabs is so satisfying, and I cannot wait to tab up this entire book. I have a really good feeling about this.
Hey guys, what's up? New outfit, new day. Wanted to do a little check-in from the last time I was reading Throne of Glass. Cusco's gonna come up and say hi. You just wanted to say hi, huh? Like I was saying, I wanted to do a little catch up just on the last couple of things that I read or like noted in Throne of Glass. I feel like last night I was just highlighting out the yin yang, making like predictions and annotations, and I was just like, I was in it. As you can see, there are quite a bit of tabs in here, and this is literally just for 90 pages. I love tabbing up a book. When I have an excuse to tab, it makes me very excited, and I feel like just the blue tabs on here are so satisfying, so I'm really excited to hopefully add a ton more into here. I did add one more note, and that was just quotes I like. So I have I just like it, predictions, and quotes I like. So I can kind of differ the like scenarios that I like or actions that I like versus quotes that are memorable and things I want to be able to reference. So as of right now, I'm on page 90, chapter 12. So again, I'm still just like a smidge in. I have been slowly crawling through this book, not for a lack of trying, not for a lack of bad like book content, just because I've been super busy with work, school, personal life, things like that. It's just been a little bit difficult to pick up a book and read for longer longer than like 20 or 30 minutes, and that is totally okay. I think it's so important to be honest about the reality of booktubers or readers in general. Everybody's on their own time. Everybody reads at their own pace. Sometimes it's faster and sometimes it's slower. Sometimes it's bigger books. Sometimes it's smaller books. And so yeah, I just feel like that's really important. Like, you see other people reading like 10 books a week, hundreds of books a year, and those are great, like, fabulous goals, fabulous accomplishments, but also it's so important to just share that not everybody can read at that pace, not everybody can read that much. So all in all, as like a little wrap up of what I've read so far, I feel like I'm finally getting to the main like beginning of the story, like the action-packed portion. I feel like I've gone through the intro and the building of this book. I've basically already read about how Selena was taken from where she was being held captive to where she is now given this offer to become the king's champion, but at the risk of a duel and like a competition kind of situation. And now she has gone with the guards and the horses and made the trek out to the glass castle and the king. And she has now been given kind of like, her sponsor is Kale, and the prince is kind of like in cahoots with it. And they're all rooting for her. Like, they know that she's gonna win, or they suspect that she's going to win, but she has to defeat all of these other competitors. So I've officially read where she's now gone to like the first competition situation, and she went to like the battle room. She got to kind of like spar with Kale, choose her weapons, and then they just went on a run to see who would be able to keep up. And like, if you couldn't, you were rooted out, you were gone. Also, there are a lot of names in this book, and I'm still trying to get used to them and like sort them out in my head. I do think it's really interesting that Kale and Dorian are actually positioning Selena as like a separate, like a different person. Like, they don't want anybody to really know her real identity. So they're positioning her and like telling everybody and telling her to tell everybody that her name is Lady Lillian, and she's not the world's best assassin. She's actually a jewel thief. And at first she was really like insulted that that was what she was supposed to tell everybody, because she's sitting amongst other assassins, other murderers, other thieves, and she's just a jewel thief. It doesn't come off as intimidating or scary, so she was really insulted because obviously she's made a name for herself, but also nobody ever knew who she was. Like, she was just Selena Sardo, then the assassin, but nobody knew what she looked like. And so she went through the first like training sparring session, and when she introduced herself, like, people were laughing at her and she was upset, and she brought it up to Kale and Dorian, like, why would you do this? And they brought it to her attention: when you were sparring, was anybody watching you? Was anybody watching your moves that you were taking, your fighting strategies? Like, was anybody threatened by you? She's like, no, nobody cared about me. So they were like, yeah, so they're not threatened by you. They think that you're gonna get killed off easily in the beginning of this competition, but lo and behold, you're probably going to win. And they're gonna think that they got beat by a jewel thief, and then you can announce that you're Selena Sardovan, the assassin. So I can see her position of being so irritated, because she is so skilled, so well known, and like really made a name for herself, even with a hidden identity. And now she's kind of like in this competition under a false identity, and nobody's afraid of her, and it is the best leverage she could possibly have. Very, very excited to dive back into this and see how much further we can get. Like I said, I'm on page 90, and I would really like to get to like page 200. I want to be like halfway done with it this weekend, and it is already Saturday, so let's see what we can read. Let's tackle some more of Throne of Glass, and let's get into it. New outfit, new day, new update on Throne of Glass. I'm so excited. So I did pretty much hit my benchmark of what I wanted to read yesterday, and that was to page 200/50%. I got to page 198. I stopped just because I wanted to stop at a chapter. I'm like 48% done, so that's super exciting. I wanted to give you guys a quick little update on what I read yesterday, because I'm pretty much after this going to go veg out on the couch and try my best to finish this and just be done with it for the weekend, and I'm pretty sure I can do it. So As a quick little recap on what I read last night, and there was quite a lot that I read. The first thing is that Selena has been competing in more and more challenges. I think that she's now completed 3 or 4, and the first one was a running challenge, then there was an archery challenge, then there was a climbing challenge, and I think it's interesting that Kale keeps telling her, like, don't show off, stay in the middle when you're running, don't hit all the targets when you do the archery challenge, and don't win and claim the gold flag first when you're doing the climbing challenge. And the climbing challenge, she actually came in second to last because she ended up saving somebody who another competitor was trying to cut the rope, so she came in second to last. That said, there have also been 3 gruesome deaths of competitors just in like disgusting ways. Somebody's like insides was all removed, somebody's body was eaten, just these like weird disgusting ways, and they don't know if it's a competitor killing off other competitors, they don't know what it is. So that's kind of something in the background that we're thinking about. And then the thing of most importance that I read last night is probably the fact that Selena discovered a hidden door in her bedroom that was part of the wall that was hidden by a tapestry. And of course she did go in and see what it was all about. She did it very strategically. She took a ball of yarn with her so she would know her way. She took candles. She left a chair in the doorway so she would be able to get back in and wouldn't be locked in this series of tunnels. And lo and behold, it was actually a way to get out. There are multiple different tunnels she could go, but the one that she went was a way to get out, and there were no soldiers or anybody watching it or guarding it. And she hesitated and thought about leaving, thought about escaping, but ultimately decided to do the right thing and still compete to be the King's champion. And if she fails, she can still escape and still have her freedom. So I thought that was very interesting. The thing that's following that is also very important is the next night Selena had this dream about the tunnels again. Basically, when she was down in the tunnels, she noticed 2 sarcophaguses, and they belonged to the original first king and queen. And then the queen's soul actually spoke to her and told her that there is a great evil in the castle. She needs to discover it. She needs to save everybody and needs to become the king's champion, and gave her this like necklace to protect her. Of course, she woke up, was startled, figured it was all a dream until she woke up and still had the necklace in her hand. So there is now this magical, like ghostly past situation that's being brought into Throne of Glass. So I'm definitely excited to see where this is gonna go, where it's gonna take us. And I have a feeling it's gonna leave off on a cliffhanger at the end of this book. I don't know why, but I'm just feeling that, like, with how it's going. Let's start reading the rest of Throne of Glass. Welcome back to the final day of this vlog, because I finally finished Throne of Glass, and though I enjoyed it, I don't truly think I loved it. And I feel a little guilty saying that. I feel like people are gonna be upset by me saying that, but different books appeal to different people, and different people have different tastes and genres and character types, and that's just how the game of reading goes. Truly, I think I rated this a 2.5/3, and that was a generous 3 on my end. I rated Never a 2-star, so I felt like this wasn't as bad as Never, but it wasn't as good as some of the other books that I rated a 3/4. I don't think it was a bad book. I truly just don't think that it was enough for me. There's certain things I look for in books, like detailed built-up characters, built-up relationships. There were just some things in this book that I wish had been more. Like, I just kept wishing for more. I do think it was a very quick read, super quick to get to the next chapter. The chapters were very short, which I did appreciate. I was just left wanting more. I felt like the challenges that Selena and the other competitors were competing in weren't really as big as they were made out to seem. They usually were about 1 to 2 pages, or it would literally be Selena competed in a recent challenge and won, or Selena competed in a recent challenge and only hit 3 out of 5 bullseyes, or something like that, where I was like, I wished I would have gotten to experience the challenge. I just felt like there was a lot of unknowns, a lot of like brief descriptions, and just kind of like sliding over the surface of situations and certain people. I do know that this is the first book in the series, so that might just have been meaning there's more to come. Or it's just a YA book, and I am starting to realize YA is not my favorite thing. because it's just very minimal, and that's okay. Some people love that. Some people enjoy that, and that is their cup of tea. For me, I just need a little bit more. That being said, I've been doing a little bit of research on when I'm supposed to read Assassin's Blade, also mixed with the feelings of if I'm going to continue this series or not. In Assassin's Blade, they say you either read first or you read third. So I'm not going to read that in this vlog. I'm kind of going to decide whether I want to move on to book number two and then of course read Assassin's Blade. I hate having a book on my shelf that I'm not going to read or don't have an interest in reading, but I also don't want to read a book just to say I read a book. If I didn't enjoy the first book, I'm nervous to read the second book. But sometimes you have to get through the first book to get to the second book. I'm conflicted, but I am on the lower end of the people who did not enjoy this book as much as others did, and that is okay. Overall, that is my book review. I hope you guys enjoyed this reading vlog. Let me know what book I should read next and share with you guys, and I will talk to you guys in my next video. Bye guys!